here once again.
Sorry, I still don't have this place set up very well for usage. I'm going to be holding onto the microphone this time, just like I was in the past two upcoming content videos. So I apologize if there's any popping on the microphone, because it's right there in front of my face. But I'm going to be doing a response video to my most recent War Thunder video, upcoming content on the XM1, General Motors, and the Chrysler XM1. And it was a rant video. Now, the reason I'm doing a response to this is because of the response I had to the video. Normally, I mean, even my Centurion AVRE got quite a few views compared to what I'm used to, and I had less than 9,200 subscribers 4 hours ago, and now I've got over that. So apparently people found these videos to be more interesting to click on, maybe not watch, but more interesting to click on, because my P40 video that I uploaded, that one got pretty popular, but up to 3,200 views over the course of 4 days. And that's actually more like 5 days if you count the day that it was recorded, as opposed to 9 hours ago and 3,300 views. So people are definitely clicking on this video. I don't know if they're clicking because it's XM1 or if they're clicking because it's a rant. Now, when I do rant videos especially, and I give my opinion, sure, I may not always give my opinion the proper way, or I may give it in a very negative way. Either way, though, my opinion's always going to be the same when I give it. But when I give it, when I go to upload the video, I always have some sort of inclination in the back of my head that I know what the viewer response is going to be. You know, I'm expecting it to be this or that. I expected this to be a negative version. People weren't going to agree with my opinion. They weren't going to, you know, they were going to be completely against the idea of it, and they were going to be all for a console exclusive and stuff like that. That actually was exactly the opposite, and we're going to look through to prove this, and to prove to Gaijin that they are making a huge mistake. I'm going to look through the website's comments, at least the first couple pages, and we're going to look through my comments section. Your comment may appear in here, and I'm not going to insult anyone directly. So if I say anything that sounds a little rude, don't take it personally. I'm talking purely about some things that people say. I will tell you right now, a majority of the comments, both on the website and on my video, are against the idea of what Gaijin's doing. So I can tell you that right off the bat. However, there are some comments that don't agree and like this idea, or not necessarily like it, but they don't find a problem with it, which is fine. And then there are the ones that really annoy me and get on my nerves, which are the people that don't understand what collecting means. And so they use that dumbass excuse that, you know, oh, they're very similar, or they are the same vehicle, you know, stop complaining about it. I kid you not, there's probably more than 10 of these fucking comments in total, overall. And it really irks me. I've heard this excuse used, like, way in the back in the day as well. I hate it. You do not understand the point of collecting if that's the case. You're not a collector. Even if you claim to be a collector, if you use that at any one point to tell somebody to stop complaining about something, then you're not a collector yourself. I'm sorry. Okay. I had somebody else post this, and I explained it to them, and they understood. On Discord, actually. So you're not going to see that. I'm not going to show my Discord, or I'm not going to show the people I talk to on Discord, at least. At least not right now. Take a drink, please. Thank you. This is probably going to be a little bit more collective. I've slept. I know my sleeping schedule is a bit screwed, so I'm probably not going to, because before I had been up all night and I had a headache, so I was kind of a little bit more itchy or touchy than normal. Let me maneuver the microphone around here for a minute. First of all, let's look on the website. Now, I posted a comment yesterday, I don't know, maybe an hour or 2 hours after the dev blog had gone up, roughly, I don't remember exactly. It was way in the rear end of the website comments. I didn't expect anyone to see this damn thing. I just posted it hoping that maybe somebody, an administrator or Gaijin or something, would see it and, you know, consider what I've said, because a lot of other people were saying very similar things. However, I posted comments on the website before, and almost always, okay, when I post a comment, maybe not always on the website, but sometimes when I would post on other areas and I'd get official responses, it would almost always be, and I should have made this video because I already looked at my comment. It did get a response from somebody, but I wish I did a thought like I did. I wish I didn't look at it before. I wanted to. I should have made my prediction because the moment that I logged on and said, if somebody responded, I bet it's SM and 1080p, and I bet he says that they're both similar or same vehicles and that they've done this in the past. Why? Because he does it so much. At least with the we've done this in the past. It's like it doesn't matter what people's opinions are now. Because we've done it in the past, it's okay to do it again. Is basically the mentality that this person has. Okay, and again, I'm not insulting him directly. I'm just saying that doesn't make any sense. And it's, again, an excuse that's been used by the administrators so many times. Is that really a reason? Oh, I mean, I killed somebody in the past, but it's okay to do it again because we did it in the past, right? No, it doesn't. Maybe that's an extreme, you know, comparison. But hopefully you get my point. I don't consider that a rightful reason to do it. My comment actually got a few upvotes, so it is now on the front page. It's not on the top of the comments, so we'll get to it here in a bit. The top comment right now, 9 hours ago, it says, "Oh, come on, why the hell are there exclusives?" 79 upvotes right now. It is currently the top comment on the website. Okay, somebody who is clearly against the idea of an exclusive, especially an exclusive for a platform that the other two of the three platforms don't get access to. Ouchie responded, an administrator, with, "The Xbox One release is a special occasion, and we have to do something special. It's not like we release a new platform or platform-exclusive vehicle every day." See, again, I'm sure these guys are being paid to talk shit or to just spew out garbage, because, again, this doesn't make any sense to me. I don't agree with it one bit, obviously. But let me explain why. It is a special occasion. I agree. But then he goes on to make the point that we don't release an exclusive vehicle every day, a console exclusive. So it's okay, just because you don't do it every day, it's okay to go and do it now? I mean, I don't understand that. It's the same thing as saying, you know, oh, we've done it in the past, so it's okay to do it again. I don't think that that's a good comparison, you know, to make. I really personally don't. And you can see that even that got a reply from this person here 8 hours ago. Ouchie's comment only got 7 upvotes, guys. 7 versus the 79. And then somebody replied to Ouchie, and it got 53 upvotes. What does this person say? "Platform exclusives are dumb, and everyone is telling developers and publishers that since they started doing them. You have numerous ways to celebrate a new platform launch, aside from giving it exclusive vehicles. You had similar outcry from people when you did it with the PlayStation exclusives, I remember, yet you somehow don't learn." That's basically Gaijin in a nutshell. "You got collectors in this game, and I bet you'd sell both variants on all platforms like candy. I, for example, would have bought both eventually if both would have been available." Same. Because I already explained this. I am a very, very, very... I find it very, very important to me to collect in this game. And I take my collection very seriously. I will purchase both packs in time. And, you know, there are so many ways that you could fix this as well. And people are probably asking, well, how do you fix it? Well, for example, if you want to have a console exclusive, here's a few ideas, right? Or maybe I should leave this for a later section of the video. I'll leave this for a later section of the video so that it's not all completely mixed up. So if you want, wait until later in the video, maybe somewhere near the end or something, and I'll talk about some ways that you could do this a little differently to make people happy. Okay, moving on. Look at the next comment 9 hours ago. This isn't pertaining to exclusives, but they're still against the idea of what they're doing here. "Holy hell, if this thing is rank 5, how is this rank 5? Should be rank 6, no. Meanwhile, the Chieftain Mark 3 is rank 6. 40 upvotes. Oh, and then here's my comment. Okay, so I posted 9 hours ago. I guess I didn't post that long after, but it was like way back on the 6th or 7th page, so I didn't expect anybody to see it. Apparently, people actually read the comments back there because I've got 39 upvotes. I posted, "Not allowing all platforms access to a vehicle is a huge mistake, especially to collectors. Please reconsider this." I wasn't I didn't like. I felt like I was pretty civil with it. I didn't insult them. I didn't call them idiots or anything in here. I just said it's a big mistake, and I'm pretty sure that the rest of the comments can prove that. But you know, and I asked politely, please reconsider this, and I stated that it's very annoying to players that are collectors, because collectors collect, obviously. And, yep, I got my response from Guess Who, and guess what he said. Both are extremely similar variants of the same contract prototype. They have minor differences, but generally offer the same style of gameplay. Platform exclusives are not new. Steam has the P36, PS4 has the A26DT45C. I don't feel like that's correct. And Xbox has the XM1 Chrysler. Again, exactly what I swear to God, it would have been 100% if I predicted this before I looked on the website, because I did, and I was exactly correct. All he did was say that they are the same vehicles, basically, or very similar, and that they've done it in the past, so it's fine to do it this time. That's dumb. Okay, and now let's get the similarity thing out of the way, because this is the thing that bothers me the most. I mean, you know, there are comments that I have of people just completely chewing me out, you know, but that's fine, because none of them say anything dumb. But then you've got the dumb ones, or excuse me, the people that say dumb things, like they're very similar, or they are the same thing, you know, or something like that, or, you know, something along those lines. The core being that both of them are very similar. Why is it such an issue? You completely do not understand the point of collecting. Why do people, you know, enjoy collecting? Why did people invest money into the T-3485E? When they found out it was going to be removed? Why did people invest money into the IS-2 Revenge when they found out it was going to be removed? What about the Canadian M5 Stuart? And countless fucking vehicles on all of the tech trees. Why? The Canadian M5 Stuart, exactly the same as the standard tech tree Stuart. The same tank. The absolute same. The only thing different, decals and paint. That is it. There's nothing else on that tank that's different. It's a carbon copy paste. But it is different because it's a different vehicle on the tech tree. It's a different little rectangle on the tech tree. It's another vehicle in the lineup, and it has a history behind it. What about the IS-2 Revenge? You could say it's the same thing, but technically it's not. It is an IS-2 1944. Same fucking vehicle, except the Revenge doesn't have a mounted machine gun on the top of the turret. Therefore, it is slightly different. But you could still argue that it's the same thing, because tank-wise, it is the same thing. Yet, it's still something people like to use and like to collect. The T-3485, it's the exact same thing as a T-3485. But guess what? This one has a couple mesh screens. May or may not help you in battle. Very minor difference. Same thing as the rest of the 85s or other 85. Yet, somehow, that one is still considered good enough to collect. You see what I'm trying to say? People collect because they are different vehicles, even if they are similar or the same. It doesn't matter. And it defeats the purpose of collecting to say, oh, they're the same thing, so I don't want it, or something like that, you know, or there's no point in complaining because they're the same vehicles. That completely defeats the purpose of collecting, guys. Absolutely does. It doesn't matter if the differences are minor, huge, if the vehicle's completely unique, or if they are the exact same carbon copy-paste vehicles. They are still another vehicle on the tech tree. That is the point to collecting. Like I said, if you don't see it that way, you're either a very casual collector, or you're not a collector at all, in my personal opinion. Because a collector isn't going to say shit like that. A collector is going to take all vehicles of the utmost importance and try to bring them in to their collection, regardless of how similar or different they look. Okay? And also to explain, or to show, yes, these vehicles are very similar. Okay? They are. But at the same time, look at the turret. The turret is, I would consider, uniquely different between these vehicles. Similar, but look at it. The turret, in the front of the turret, this vehicle is very different looking in the turret department. Okay? Despite how similar the performance may be, or the armor may be, or whatever, or the gun, this vehicle still is not just a carbon copy-paste like a lot of other collectibles are. So why is this one also getting that, you know, that treatment from people? I don't know. I know why, or at least I have an idea why. It's like I said, I don't think these people understand the point of collecting, or they aren't collectors themselves. And if they are, they're very casual collectors, so they'll only collect here and there. But I don't really consider that a collector. I consider you're either a collector or you're not. You know, if you're not a collector, you just play the game, buy what you want to play, have fun with it, go through it. If you're a hardcore collector, you try to get absolutely every single vehicle you can, regardless of what it is or how similar it is to something else, and you collect it, and that's where you get a lot of your enjoyment from. Keep in mind, guys, I play and really enjoy this game. All the vehicles, standards, premiums, because I have been playing, when I was playing War Thunder about a week or so ago, I have been playing the standard tech trees, grinding modifications and stuff like people wanted me to do. That's what I'm doing. I enjoy the vehicles that I have and play and premiums and collectibles. But I also get a ton of my enjoyment out of collecting. Tons and tons of it. I have papers up on my wall right now. And on these papers, each paper is different. One paper's Air Forces, one's Ground Forces, and then when Naval Forces is released, I'll have another paper up. These papers have every single nation and every single vehicle in the game that I don't own, including premiums and exclusives. Every single one. If I can stand up here, this may be a really bad idea. I'm now holding the microphone up here. I don't know how different I sound. But I'm standing up. Like, if I bring it over here slightly. Here, like I'll stand over here and we'll look at it. Like, so if we look at the United States Air Force on the aviation list, you'll see I've got things like the F-3D1, you know, and the F-84, the new F-84, the B-57B, two of the Sabres, stuff that I don't have, right? But then if you keep going down, you got the X-8-38 Grizzly. That's a premium. Yeah, it's a premium. I don't own it. It's not an exclusive, but I don't own it, so it's on the list. And when I own these, I obviously cross them off. You keep going down, and you see that the P-26A-35. Oh, that was removed in the alpha stages. That's a collectible. I don't have it. It's on the list. The A-26C-45DT. It's on the list. PlayStation 4 exclusive. And then we have very last one, the P-40F, because that was just announced. You know, and obviously I don't have it because it's not out yet. I've added both XM1s to the United States Ground Forces list, and the Russian Air Forces has all of the collectibles that they have from the very early stages of the game. There's no shortage of it. Okay, I take collecting very seriously, and I write down and keep track of every vehicle in the game that I don't own, including collectibles. I have multiple papers all over my desk, all the same thing, that all have listed every collectible in War Thunder. Every single one of them. Every removed or hidden vehicle, every collectible, whatever. All of them. And I have multiple lists because sometimes I lose one and I need another one. So there's one over here, one in the top cubby, one on the left. In fact, I think there's two or three on the left. All right, and I'll probably make another one in the next couple months. It's just a habit of mine because I'm keeping track of them. And, you know, maybe it's my internal dream whoring that I have, but I plan to either hopefully someday Gaijin comes to their senses and makes these vehicles available, whether for a limited time or permanently, for all platforms. But in my brain, the only thing that I can really try to do right now, other than voice our concerns to a company that doesn't fucking listen to anything, is to play the shit out of the game and unlock every single vehicle, every premium, and basically just do absolutely everything I can. Fully modify every single vehicle, and then maybe I can start getting collectibles just given to me like other YouTubers. I'm not going to name who, but there are various YouTubers that mysteriously gain access to collectibles despite having never taken part in the event, or they gain access to collectibles a month before they're even added for everyone else. And the only thing I can find that reacts to this, because they either don't have that many subscribers or they do, is that they have every vehicle in the game, they have every premium, they've fully unlocked all modifications, they've basically done absolutely everything in the game, and I guess they get rewarded. And that's fine. I consider that a perfectly fine reward. If you completely kick the game's ass, a reward should be, oh, here, you know what, let's give you some extra goodies for all of your dedicated time and work. That's what I'm going to try and do. It's probably not going to work, but hey, it's worth a try, right? We'll see what happens in the next 3-4 years when I actually reach that point. But anyways, maneuvering on from that, I just wanted to bring up the point of how serious I take collecting, because every vehicle is important to my collection, not just collectibles, but standards and premiums as well. Collectibles especially, though, because of how they're limited time and various other things like that. Those are, you know, there was somebody that posted a comment saying that they should make the exclusives, all exclusives, available for everybody. And I stated that if I had control over War Thunder for one day, where I could make the decisions, the big boy decisions, and, you know, just for one day, or maybe even half a day, the first thing I would do, okay, because I wouldn't have time to completely rework the battle rating system or anything like that. That would take days and days of work. Well, in my opinion, at least. What I could do, or what I would do, is I would unlock every fucking collectible vehicle in existence on every single tech tree for everyone to get. Now, because I wouldn't have the game under my control forever, it would only be a limited time. So what I would do is I would do something like what they did at the LA 174, maybe, or what, 179? I don't remember, that special LA variant jet that they have. I would do something probably similar to that, where you can grind them out for RP or something. You know, you get the P26A35 for like 1200 RP or something like that. So you just play one round in air battles and you've got yourself a collectible right there. And it's just everybody scrounging to get as many collectibles as possible. You know, and if I had the game in control for as long as time went on, all collectible, there would be no collectibles. I don't care if it hurts business or whatever. I would care that the player base has the option to collect on themselves without feeling the stress of either missing ones or having ones like this pop up that are exclusive to a certain console that they can't, that they don't have access to, and thus they get really stressed out because of it. I mean, because you have to also understand, there are plenty of people that join the game now, as well as, you know, when I joined the game, I was in the same boat. The only way that this doesn't happen to you is if you join the game, if you were gained access to the game, like, the first day that it started alpha testing, or something like that. That's pretty much the only way you wouldn't apply to this. But a lot of us didn't have a fair chance at getting collectibles, because we joined too late. I joined in April 2013, which was pretty damn early, but it was still too late. There were tons of collectibles that had passed by already from the alpha stages that were removed, that people got to keep, or that people were gifted for taking part in the test. Various other things like that. The P39Q15, the P26A35, the SB2Ms, the Year 2s, the SM79s, which I actually have those. And what was the other? There was another set of like bombers. No, I think that was it. I could be wrong. Take another drink here. You know, stuff like this. Player comes into the game now. They start playing, you know. I didn't take collecting seriously when I first started playing. It took almost a full year before I actually started to think, hey, you know what? Collecting's fun. And then that's when I became a hardcore collector. And ever since, when I started that in 2014, I didn't miss a single collectible vehicle at all until Thunder League, when they introduced the horrible event system and the tournament rewards. Well, they already had a tournament system, but any vehicles that were in the tournaments were aside the tournaments, not in the tournaments themselves, if you know what I mean. Like the Gladiator Mark IIs, that was alongside the Gladiator tournament. But guess what? All you had to do was just play the game normally to unlock it and get it for free. You didn't have to take part in the tournament and be top number player or whatever. You know, back when Gaijin weren't idiots. Oh, wait, I wasn't supposed to insult people. Excuse me. I slipped up on my words a little bit. Back when Gaijin actually cared about what people said and didn't just completely go against people for the sake of going against them. And then I went back and I continued to collect, and then they just continued to do these things over and over again, these tournaments. And when they would do them, thankfully there weren't really that many new vehicles except like the KV-1B or returning collectibles that I had missed in the past, like the XF-5 of Skyrocket, things like this. But I don't think I actually officially missed another collectible, a new collectible, until 2017, when the HE-162 was announced in a tournament, and thus it just rinse and repeat, right? And now I'm missing another one. I guess I didn't include the PlayStation 4 A26, because that I also missed, because I didn't have a choice. That was, you know, PlayStation 4 only. So scrolling down here, back down to where my comment is. Let's see if there anybody had replied. So SMN 1080p surprisingly got 0 upvotes. And he has a response for 7 upvotes that says, I find console exclusives to be an insult to the largest percent of the player population, the PC. Why cater to a fledgling populace in a console that might not take off, and leave the loyal PC populace without any vehicle or without a vehicle they could have acquired if it wasn't for exclusives? It is a slap to the in the face. War Thunder, redact this decision. So once again, somebody who doesn't agree with the idea of making something console exclusive. Now, see, I complained in the video also about premium. You have to understand, I wasn't complaining about one of them being a premium. I was complaining that one of them was a premium and the other was an exclusive. Not the fact, you know, if both of them were premiums, but available for everybody, so be it. What I was complaining about was that both of them were premiums and one you couldn't even get. You know, and I felt that that was completely unnecessary and didn't really make much sense or wasn't consistent with some of the other vehicles that have been coming out. So that was what my main complaint in the last video was. Did anybody else post down here? Here's somebody. Big mistake by Gaijin. Just wait until everyone realizes that to own one of these, you either have to buy one or get an Xbox to own the other another one. We don't even get any benefit from War Thunder Xbox, so why should we lose the opportunity to own the tank? 8 upvotes. Any more, or is that it? No, that's it. The next person isn't on the topic of exclusives again, but they do say, now honestly, so why wasn't the Leopard 2K a premium and the Leopard 2A0, A1, whatever, the actual tech tree tank, whatever, still a very good looking model, 35 upvotes. And yeah, it is a very good looking model. It doesn't, you know, it doesn't matter what the circumstances are. Whenever there's a new vehicle developed for this game, it is absolutely gorgeous. They do a fantastic job, the modeler teams. They are absolutely talented when it comes to this stuff. They got an official response saying the 2K is too powerful to be in rank 5, but apparently the XM1 isn't. Are the XM1 that bad? Wouldn't seem like it. 7 upvotes. Well, let's see. Next one is, why don't you put one of them in normal tech tree? 29 upvotes. The answer is, from official response, is that they're prototypes, and we need to release premium vehicles from time to time. All right. You've got 2 massive issues with this, Ouchie. I'm sorry. I really hope you were paid to say this, because otherwise you don't play your own game. They're prototypes. That's why they're premium. Okay? How many fucking prototypes are not premium? Even the Leopard 2K, recently added, not premium. I don't care if it's top rank either. You have to understand my point here, okay? And we need to release premium vehicles from time to time? What about the last update when you added a shit ton of bundle packs? The Magok 3, the MB5, the AMX 30, you know, and before that, new bundle packs. Don't tell me you need to release a premium vehicle from time to time when you just released 3 major bundle packs, 2 of which were $50 fucking. And now you've gone and released 2 more, both very expensive. You understand? I think that is really dumb to bring up that excuse. It makes sense if maybe we haven't had a premium, or maybe we only had 1 premium last month, last update, or something like that. As opposed to, you know, getting a shitload of premiums and then turning around and getting a shitload more premiums. And by a shitload of premiums, I mean 3 bundle packs? That's a lot, in my opinion. It's not the same as adding just a premium to the tech tree. A bundle is quite a bit bigger because they often tend to be a lot more expensive because you have to pay for extra stuff. Anyways, that was 29 upvotes versus his 9 upvotes. And the response to that is, can we now get the ERA for Magok 3 then? 12 upvotes. Okay. Continuing on. I don't understand. Maybe some meme thing. I don't exactly understand what that one is. And then the final comment on the first page is, shame that you have to play it on Xbox to get the other variant. I wonder if they will reconsider this. 18 upvotes. Okay, so we've got 1, 2, well, we've specifically got 1, 2, or 2 down here, and 3 main comments upvoted on the front page that are against the idea of them being exclusives. Then we have ones against the idea of it being a premium or something along those lines. And then we have tons of fucking replies here of people either agreeing with shitloads of upvotes, more so than the administrator's response, you know, or something along those lines. And then we have a couple other ones in here, again, that may not be on the topic of exclusives, but they're on the topic of not liking the idea of this either way. Okay, so, you know, and that's just scratching the surface. There's more and more pages here on the website, but I think the most important ones to look at are the front page ones, the ones that most people have seen, and the ones that have the most upvotes. That alone should tell Gaijin that something they're doing probably isn't right, right? Well, if there's any place for disagreements and arguments, it's my video comment section. That is usually the biggest place where people will get into huge disagreements, either with me or with each other, and they'll start, you know, they'll start ripping each other's throats out. Holy shit, is that really not the case this time? And when that happens, Gaijin, you know you done fucked it up. You really do. When one of my videos is not ripping each other to pieces. All right, let's pop on over to the YouTube comment section here. I'm going to go ahead and refresh the page quick because I'm sure some comments have come in. Now, this is on a bright white screen, and I wear glasses, and I have a little bit of a sensitivity to the bright screens. That's why I use the dark theme most of the time. But when you're in Creator Studio, apparently the dark theme does not apply, unless you need to use YouTube Studio Beta. I'll have to try that out later. So I apologize if I have a little bit of an issue reading these. Okay, so shit. Hold on. I gotta set the microphoner down quick. Hold on. Have your patience, please. Patience, young Patty Wan. Okay. That should be good enough. Okay. Pick up the microphone again. Microphoner. Alright, so continuing on here, the first comment, which was posted 5 minutes ago, let's see. We'll see if they agree or if they disagree with me or whatever. We'll see. I simply target players in-game that have the locked content, like the PES4 A26. I'll chase them all game and make sure they don't get any points. Looks like I'll have to nuke the X-boners now. Okay. I don't exactly know if that's agreeing with me, but obviously they chase down people with the exclusives, I guess because they're locked content. So I can understand that, but 12 minutes ago, that makes sense. Why is the Leopard 2K not a premium and not have the Leopard 2 AV on the tech tree? So probably in response to that top comment that we read. Driving a T64B will be a lot of fun with all the Xbox premium twats and the ERA package. So people complaining that the Xbox players will be crap. I already went over this whole thing in my Xbox video that I did when they announced it back in like October or November or something like that. I explained that, you know, the different, you know, the judgments that console players get when, you know, 99% of the time they are in no way whatsoever true. unfortunately we still get comments like that, but whatever. 22 minutes ago, personally, I don't care for the Chrysler variant, but I'm annoyed that this is how Gaijin wants to play it. They decide to add the Centurion AVRE instead of the Churchill AVRE. Oh, that's not... Okay, we're going to skip comments on the non-video. Okay, moving on. Here we go. Are all consoles and PC players play on the same servers? I know the PS4 and PC players play on the same servers. I don't know if they're going to do that with the Xbox. I really don't. Oh, and that brings up... We might get to it here. That brings up... The Chinese tech tree. Somebody basically was telling me, you're complaining about this, but you're not complaining about the Chinese tech tree. I did complain about the Chinese tech tree before because I wanted all those vehicles, but that's slightly a different cup of tea because, slightly different a bucket of water because that's a completely separate tech tree on a completely separate server, not developed directly from Gaijin Entertainment. So it's technically not the same thing. Therefore, I don't care. I don't have an issue. I'm not sitting here like, oh, we have all this locked content because it's on a completely separate standalone server, for the Chinese players and shit like that. That's why we don't. It'd be different if we saw the Chinese tech tree and Chinese tanks rolling around in our server from their tech tree. Then yes, I'd have a problem because, in the case that the Xbox will be separated, from our servers. In that case, the Chrysler version, you're not going to see rolling around, but that still means I'm still going to have a problem with it, because in this case, it's directly, officially Gaijin Entertainment, and is being advertised alongside the PC version and PS4 version of the game. Therefore, it rubs it in my face, and I have an issue with it. Fucking gay, I'd rather have the... Oh, that's the Churchill again. I haven't heard that gay thrown around in a long time. Been playing on the PS4 for about 2 years. Can't wait to play more on my Xbox. Okay, somebody wanted to play on their Xbox. I don't know if you're going to be able just to log in on your Xbox, or if you're going to have to do the PS4 thing and create a whole new account that's, you know, unique to that. Because there's somebody in here, I think, that said, easy loophole, just log into a friend's account, or like a friend's Xbox with your War Thunder, buy it there, and then log out. If that's okay, if that's how it works, okay, so be it. Then yeah, sure. But I doubt that's how it's going to work. I'm pretty sure you're going to have to use your Xbox account. Versus, you can't just log in with your PC account. Just like on the PlayStation, you have to use a PlayStation account. Your PlayStation account or whatever. At least that's how I would assume it. If that's not how it works, then yeah, there is a loophole to this whole thing. And then there is no reason to really be complaining, because everybody... Except, well, I guess there is a reason to complain, because PS4 players still can't get it. Only the PC players can. Then in that case, yeah, there is still a reason to complain. Never mind. Okay. What's going to happen is Xbox players are going to buy this and think, wow, and then they get thrown into a 7.3 and 7.7 match and get wrecked. Then everyone else is going to get pissed because they don't know how the game works. Going to be messed for a while. Oh, it's going to be the jingles effect. Yeah, that's probably how it's going to be. What happens when all these new players get this tank and have never played the game before and get destroyed and everyone else gets pissed? That's basically the same thing he just said. No, not that one. Are you telling me there are two premium XM1s for $50? Yes, but one's separate, and you can't actually get it. Unless you want to load up your Xbox. Next one is, I see every country is getting up the ass as far as planes, except the USA again. Britain needs jets. Well, what do you mean USA again? They get the P-40. What about the French? They get the F-4U. Come on. and wasn't there something else added? No, I think there's only two planes so far. Yeah, the planes haven't been getting the focus of the content in the past few major updates, so I can understand why people would be a little bit annoyed with this. Scrolling down again, okay, the next one is, the other issue is they're getting huge gaps in the tech tree. The Leo 2K was in the tech tree, so they have a space there for other MBT prototypes to create a mid... BR gap top tier and tier 4. Instead, we now have America's prototypes in the premiums. They'll end up with nothing to flesh out and fix the broken BR's top tier. I've got to read more here. Also, does this mean your profile isn't shared between Xbox and PC? Was kind of hoping I could use the Xbox for War Thunder on the move, but not really responsible if I have to... reasonable if I have to start again. And as you said, annoying if there's no way to get this vehicle for PC. Was hoping you could buy it through Xbox for PC. So basically, they're saying the exact same thing I said, where you could log into to Xbox and buy it there and then just go back to the PC. But no, I don't think that's how it's going to work. I think it's going to have to be separate. And if it's not, you know, okay. But that's how I feel it's going to be. I mean, I don't own an Xbox One, so it's not like it'll make any difference for me anyways. I'm just waiting for the Xbox version to release, and Tigerfrost, why you have to be mad? I understand why, but hey, new tanks, new toys, am I right? Oh, and then this was right when I woke up. I responded with, not a new toy when you can't use it. And it looks like he responded back. At least you're playing with one toy. One is better than nothing. I kind of want to say something else, but I don't want to piss anyone off. You've already pissed me off. No, I'm kidding. This isn't the same thing as saying, you know, oh, they're both the same, so shut the fuck up. You know, it's not that dumb shit. But yes, it's true. One is better than none. Okay. If you have two, it's better to have at least one than none, but I still don't think that means we shouldn't complain about it. We shouldn't have, you know, negativity towards their decisions. I really don't think that that's the way it should be going. I don't know. Maybe you think a little bit differently than me on that. Whatever. The comment section will be open. Keep in mind, all of these comments are posted. There's none that have been removed. There's none that have been, well, actually, is there any spam? No, there's no likely spam or anything. So all of the comments on here, just post away whatever the fucking garbage you have to say. None of it is being filtered around at all. And if any go in the likely spam, I just click the little check mark and get it back on the thing. Unfortunately, YouTube detects a lot of comments as auto spam, especially people that post comments often. I've noticed even when they're not saying shit about anything, they'll just say like, "Oh, I'm so excited the Chrysler, you know, is coming to the Xbox," or you know, something like that. You know, and then all of a sudden it's likely spam because YouTube thinks they're spamming because they post on like all of my videos. That's a problem. I don't like that. Other times people can report a comment for spam over and over again and get it sent to my spam folder or get it removed altogether. I can't stop that, unfortunately. I'm sorry if that happens to you. Okay, moving on. I was considering purchasing the XM1 Chrysler. Then I see that it is Xbox One exclusive. Nice marketing, Gaijin. You pissed off everyone to please a player base that isn't even there yet. I completely agree. Correct me if I'm wrong, but this is technically a Tier 6 premium, is it not? Technically, probably, yeah. 2 hours ago. Excuse me. Look at it from the bright side. With these insta-get vehicles, the matchmaking time won't take 5 to 10 minutes for M1 Abrams anymore. American teams at high tier will fill up more quickly and thus reducing lobby time. I don't know, I don't play the M1 Abrams yet because I don't have it, so there's no bright side for me. There's only dark side. And then you get this one here. I remember looking at this when I woke up. Why are you so salty on my Centurion video? What? Why would you post... If you're gonna use that stupid salty crap, why would you post it on the video where I am overwhelmingly excited and not the video where I rant for like 16 minutes? That makes no sense, Mr. People's Republic of Liberland, okay? I'm sorry, that made me laugh when I woke up because I was like, wait, what's so salty in my Centurion video? I don't remember being angry about anything in there. I was only excited when I was looking at the announcement for that vehicle. What the fuck is going on with my cords? Oh, okay. Alright, moving along. I do get the marketing part, but really, exclusive vehicle to promote a game? PC player is your backbone of the game and you are going to put a wall on them. I agree. This is stupid. I also collect vehicles. The only tank I don't have is the E-100. Same here. The only tank. Unless you count the standards, I don't own either. But the only collectible I don't own for ground forces is the E-100. I got all hidden vehicles. I even got the Leg 3-4. Oh, shit. We're talking to a special case here. I got it from the pre-alpha test. So I have played and collect vehicles for like 7 years. 6 years. Might be pushing 5. And to make an Xbox-only vehicle is so stupid. So we're talking to, you know, a bona fide badass here, right? No, I'm being serious. They've got the Leg 3-4, and they were part of the alpha test, pre-alpha test, apparently. And in that case, yes, we got to listen to one of these guys. Same with me. The only ground vehicle I don't own is the E-100. I own every other ground vehicle. I don't own nothing like the Leg 3-4, but... You know, that's on my list. I would love to own it someday. It looks beautiful. I like the paint scheme that it's got. And I don't think that many people actually own it. The M1 Abrams is too OP. Gaijin XM1 is their response to it. Hold on, I gotta take another drink. Sorry, my mouth is really dry. Since I just woke up. I woke up about an hour ago now. We're rolling on 43 minutes. Tinyon, how's your PC, by the way? Just people asking shit. What's the release date? Oh, of course. On my Xbox video. Fuck off. I think he went and posted that because I said that in my Chrysler and General Motors video. I was like, because look at this video here. If I open this video, look, 24,000 views. October 27, 2017. So many people post comments on this video. So many people, look, 323 comments. I'm still, over the course of months and months, 5 months, you know, 6 months, over, you know, even up to only a few weeks ago, I get comments on this video of people asking me, when's it going to release? Oh my god. I don't know. I just cover the news. I'm not going to know when they're going to release a whole fucking new console thing. And I think this guy's just taking the piss. He went and posted the comment because I was like, stop telling or stop asking me. You know, so, yeah, whatever. Moving on. As a PlayStation player, I feel touched. Tier 5 premium, ha 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 ha. They know that all the whales are on Xbox, so I'm not surprised. Wow, that's a bit... Well, more food for my A1A1 and 50k left Leo 2K. What about... Okay, that's the wrong video. Honestly, everyone is more worried about the ability of buying vehicles or buying these vehicles instead of worrying possibility of them completely breaking tier 5 matches. Not everybody is worrying about that. We already showed on the website that people are already questioning, you know, the problems that this might cause for that tier. I wasn't, because I'm not very experienced in that top tier region yet. I mean, I've been playing a lot more of it in the recent half year, but I'm still not very experienced in it, so I can't really give my opinion too much on that because I don't know. But I'm seeing lots of people complain about it, so obviously. So it looks like there's three groups of people here. We have the people that are that I'm part of that are angry about it being a collectible exclusive for a platform that nobody else can get access to. Then we have the group of people like this that are angry about it being a tier 5 premium. And then we have the third group of people, which is about, you know, 0.3% of people that are against our opinions and completely agree with Gaijin because they're weird. Obviously, that's not the case. If you're fine with it, that's perfectly fine. I'm talking about the 0.3% of people that use the excuses like they're the same vehicles, etc., etc. Oh boy, here we go. Okay, let's see. As somebody that's mostly a collector of US and UK tanks, I was so excited when I saw the dev blog for these two beauties. I was too. I was like, ooh! You know, when I got the leak video sent to me, I was like, oh shit, this looks awesome. We're going to be getting the X1. I posted it on Twitter and everything, and I sent it to somebody on Discord and stuff. I was like, hey, this is going to be great. And then I saw the dev blog and was like, oh, yes, two of them. Hell yes, one on the standard tech tree, one as a premium. I'll sell my nuts. And then all of a sudden, I had to cut the video, and I had to completely scrap the first try because I realized, oh, no, that's not what's up. Nope, you fucked up. Shit. Anyways, I'd even be fine with both of them being premium. Same. If, you know, one wasn't a fucking console exclusive. What is it even supposed to accomplish? Not even I will start the game over on another machine for that. How about this? Make General Motors version premium on the Xbox and the Chrysler version premium on the PC, PS4. Or the other way around. Or make both premium on all machines. It should be premium on all machines. Well, this shouldn't be fucking this shit anyways. But make one version less or even more expensive depending on the platform. Anything. I can think of quite a few more ways that would probably be better for everyone. Remember, I'm not trying to shit on Xbox here. I want everyone to get this vehicle. Okay? And that's why... Hold on, I have an itch. That's why it irks me so much. I have had such a fucking... You know, it has been so important to me for collecting that I value other people's collecting as well. That's why when I see other people in distress about collectibles, I completely understand. Even if they're collectibles, even if I own, if there's an event and I already own the collectibles, if it's a tournament, you know, oh, two big vehicles in there in this tournament, I own both of them, I'm still pissed. What about all the fucking other people that don't own them? You know, or if there's an event of vehicles that I already own, I still cover it on my channel to let people know, hey, look, if you don't have these vehicles, go and get them. Come on. You know, stuff like that. I don't just value my own collection. I care about everyone else that likes collecting as well. Thus, I'm trying to fight not just for myself, but for everyone on this matter. I think all players, PlayStation, PC, and Xbox, should get access to all vehicles. None of this exclusive crap. I didn't do a really good job, but I was trying to make the comparison to, like, other console exclusives and stuff, and game exclusives that you get. In other games, in my last video, I had said something like, I was talking about various games like Terraria and stuff. They get all, like, there's mobile versions, and then there's console versions, and they all in PC versions. All of these versions have complete exclusive content, PC having the most. You know, and it's like, why? It's shit. It's really shit. Now I feel stupid for buying the Israeli M60. Wasn't it an M48, not an M60? I don't know. Maybe they changed that. In other words, he's saying he should have waited and gotten this thing. Well, you can say that now in hindsight, but at the time, you had no idea. Nobody knew the XM1 was going to be coming right now. So, yeah. What the fuck, dude? I keep getting my cords all tangled up my ass. All right, moving on. Let's scroll down here. Let's see what this person says. As soon as I read this dev blog, even though I'm not subscribed to you and only sometimes catch your videos in my recommended, I just had to search your channel up to hear your opinion. I have no regrets. Edit, I am now subscribed. Welcome. You probably won't be subscribed for long once I start uploading more Mass Effect. That's a Fallout video. Okay, here we go. To be honest, I'm not surprised. Not surprised that Gaijin's dumb. Yes, me neither. Moving on. Wow, rank 5 Xbox exclusive. Fuck off, Gaijin. If they start to prioritize consoles, I'm not politically correct. I play on PC for 5 years. You prioritize other platform, I'll just give zero money to you from now on. Boycott. They should have at least released both as premium on, for all platforms, or release two Chrysler models and make one premium for the Xbox and one for the, in the tech tree. Oh, I see what they're saying. Which, I mean, I guess I can kind of understand that, but I don't think they've ever done that before, and I don't really see them doing that. So, I don't know, I'd be kind of on in the middle board on that one if they actually did that. It'd be better than what they're fucking doing now, though. Wait, so there is a friggin' Tier 5 Abrams now. Not that I'm complaining, but why is it Tier 5? Aside from it being a premium, I also agree with you, Tigerfrost. Okay, moving along. That's only got one little upvote. We're probably not going to see all the mega upvote ones, because these are recent comments. All the, like, the first comments are the ones that got all the freaking upvotes and shit. Angry just because... Oh, shit, we might have found the first person that doesn't agree. Angry just because it's only for Xbox. I can't understand why. Seems that some people forget that Gaijin is a company. They are there to make money. You're completely wrong on that. They are there to make money, but they could make far more money by allowing it for all three platforms. Some people are saying... I've seen this around a couple times now. People saying that they're going to make a lot more money by putting it on Xbox. How are they making more money? Maybe if, like, they made a deal with Microsoft or something, you know, and it's being sponsored. How are they going to make more money on Xbox? They would make far more money by making it available for all three platforms, because then you have three different player bases buying the pack. This excuse that they got to make money is really dumb, okay? Because they're going to make more money if they allow it for everybody. And if you know, and knowing that it's a vehicle like that, people aren't going to just sit by and not buy it. It's not going to be, you know, another case of like the BE6 or something like that, where it doesn't sell very well. No, they're going to fucking buy the shit out of this tank. So I don't want to hear this crap about they need to make money. And they do need to make money. I understand that. I understand why they release premiums and stuff like that. But I get it, right? But when they release them in this way, that's when I get angry. They are here to make money. Okay, we already got past that. And the only ones that aren't angry are the ones that get everything without buying things. You guys already have the fucking M1 and the next M1A1. So why you have to be mad? Oh, he says you guys already have... This must be coming from an Xbox player. Which, again, if that's the case, and he's saying you guys already have the M1 and next the M1A1, is dumb because you on the Xbox are also going to have the M1 and the M1A1. That's not fair. That's not a fair comparison to make, sir. If that's the comparison he's trying to make. By saying, oh, I'm going to be an Xbox player, so it's you guys already have the M1, so stop complaining. Well, you guys are going to have it too! I wonder, I don't know if I want... No. It said that the General Motors is exclusive, so... I mean, in a way, the Xbox is also getting screwed because they can't get the General Motors version. So both, all parties here are being shit on for this, which is bullshit. All right, moving along. This is just stupid. They should give Xbox, the game can't even be played on it, what the fuck, an exclusive decal or something, not a complete tank. Makes no sense. See, if it was like a cosmetic or maybe a title or something like that, even though I collect a lot of these things, that's fine, I think, as an exclusive. Maybe some special exclusive title for being one of the first Xbox players to play when it releases on Xbox, you know, some badass title for that or something, right? I think that would be cool. You know, and I think that would be fine. But no, I agree. Not a whole fucking tank. Let alone a rank 5 tank. Premium. Okay? Holy shit. Show more. Moving on. Can anyone tell me why anybody would buy the Magok 3 now? Nobody would. Unless you're weird and are a collector. And that's an interesting thing. I didn't buy the Magok 3. It was given to me. And it doesn't actually register that I own the pack on the website. So I don't actually own it, but I do own it, if that makes any sense. No, that's the Centurion. That's on my computer video. That's a completely different video. That's Skyrim. Holy shit. Where the fuck are all my... There we go. This is beyond stupid, even for Gaijin standards. Now USA has 4 premium... Wait, what? 4 premiums? Tier 5... I guess they're counting both the Chrysler and General Motors versions. While everyone else has one or none at all. These Tier 5 tanks are just Tier 6 tanks in disguise. And exclusive content? What the actual fuck is this? Okay. I 100% agree with you, mate, is the next comment. Next comment is, I think it would be fine if they were both available to everyone, but if you bought an Xbox One, you get the XM1C for free. Well, hey, that's an interesting idea. I didn't even think about that. But it should be able to buy it no matter what platform you're on, obviously. I think if I play on PC, the login on a PS4, then my stuff should be there. Same if I have an Xbox and the XM1C, I log on the PC, you're depriving me of my purchase, whatever. Depriving me of purchase, yes. I would purchase this fucking tank. You know, that's $50 that Gaijin's not getting. I can't purchase it now, but I would purchase it. And that's $50 that Gaijin aren't getting from me now. And from plenty of other people because it's not available. You sit there on your PS4, you sit there on your PC. Can't buy it? Well, guess it's $50 they're not getting. See, again, that's why I'm asking. How are they getting more money by releasing it on Xbox and not releasing it on all platforms? That doesn't make any sense to me. Yeah, people are going to buy it. They're going to get a nice little cash grab. You know how much bigger of a cash grab they'd get if they, you know, if they released it on all platforms? I mean, dude. Look on the bright side, plenty of noobs at rank 5 to feed on. I don't know, I don't play rank 5 regular enough to do that. At least the PS4 A26 was similar enough to the other rare event A26 that if you ask most people wouldn't even notice the difference. Okay, this person's agreeing, but he's agreeing wrongfully. Well, I've already given my opinion on this same thing. I think pretty much the only major difference between the PS4 A26 and the PC one is that the PS4 one can carry like a shit ton of rockets and stuff. I think that's pretty much the only difference. But other than that, they're still both uniquely different in that they're two different separate vehicles. Therefore, I don't want to apply this same thing to it. Moving along. The salt mines are going to be empty. They are going to be empty. All the salt has been fucking mined right the hell out. In fact, I think they're empty already. Gaijin has done it again, directly against the player base, and fucked up again. I don't like the imbalance of rank 5 premiums, but not as much as they're going to be, or not as much as they're being exclusives to certain platforms. I also think it's unfair that the American's prototype is premium, but the German's isn't. Also, I pray to God the Leo 2s get added, or I don't know the other three variants of the Leo 1s. I also hope Heat, I guess is what he's talking about, not Heath, gets fixed for the AVRE. Or maybe he's talking about Hesh instead of Heat. It's going to be trash, not to mention other easy and minor changes that need to be made. It feels like Gaijin likes fucking up. They do. They like to do really awesome, make awesome game, make awesome tank, but then they turn around and they screw something up. And the problem with Gaijin is they don't fucking fix it. This is my opinion on Gaijin. It'd be awesome if one of you guys are watching right now at Gaijin Entertainment, okay? It'd be awesome if one of you are watching right now. It seems like Gaijin's problem is they do a great job at making one of the badass tank or one of the badass games of all time, and they make beautiful tanks and planes and beautiful battles and stuff, and it's just an awesome game. But then they fuck something up somewhere, whether it be a tournament or like this, you know, or something else. And the community outcries about it, and sometimes even like now with tournaments and stuff, continue to outcry about it since the day it started. But Gaijin doesn't listen or fix the issue. They'd like to break things and leave them broken. I can only think of a few times with like maybe balancing or various things like that where they actually went out of their way to fix it. And possibly maybe naval forces. That was about it. So yeah, I don't know how I feel. Shit. I don't know how I feel about this. This form of government in their company right now. PC gets access to the market and user-made camos and several other features. Super large discount bundles in the store during Christmas and other exclusive sales is something also exclusive to PC. It does suck that it is a console exclusive, but when looking at the whole overall system, console, especially because of Sony, do not have good access compared to PC players. It is an attempt by Gaijin to draw an Xbox group of players to the game. It does suck, but it is understandable. It is not understandable for me. I understand the idea that PC has a lot of exclusive shit, which is what I tried to explain in the video of stuff that needs to be changed because I want access to everything for everybody. But I don't consider it fully understandable to me myself. And this is the way that they should be doing things. I don't agree with the way that they should. I don't think I agree with that. This is the way they should be doing things. If they wanted to make more money, they wouldn't have exclusives. That doesn't make any sense. What? This person's basically saying they have exclusives so that they make more money. What? How does that make more money? How are they getting more money from the Xbox version? That doesn't make any sense. It's not even a version that people play right now. It's going to have a player base when it releases, but that still doesn't make any sense. You've got all of these players on PC, thousands and thousands and thousands, tens of thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of players on PC and PS4 alike. Oh, but they're going to make more money when they make it exclusive for Xbox. That makes no fucking sense. That doesn't make any sense one bit. Now I found a second freaking excuse that I don't agree with. References. I would never ever pay $49.99 for a tank, especially for this shit tank. Not. Oh no, he's talking about Centauri. Never mind. I was gonna say. It's like what? Custom battle. GG custom battles. GG tier 5. I hate the look of the Abrams in game. It looks like it just came out of the factory. No bag. Oh, I can agree with that, but I still think it looks pretty. Soldier things, you know, the things that put you on the tank that makes it look battle hardened. The T-64B has many of those, like toolboxes, etc., etc. The Abrams, I would imagine that these issues are going to be solved, like with the M1A1 or something like that, maybe. Moving along. I'm so pissed with the way Gaijin is going with this new patch. My War Thunder profile is going to suffer from this. My collection is fucked. Now, not a happy chappy. P.S. I'm totally behind you with the response to this. Utter joke. Rant over. Well, your rant was much shorter than mine. especially if you want to consider this a rant. It's over an hour long now. Just fucking let them have it. It's almost the same, dude. Okay? Dumb. we already went over that. I don't have to sit here and explain it again for right now. What the fuck is the point? Super stupid. War Thunder really sucks at reading their community. They do. I do agree. They just do whatever and hope it works. And then they hope it works, and then when it doesn't work, they don't fix it. See, what the hell, dude? I'm probably not going to read through all of these because there's like a shit ton of comments. Maybe I'll click on the video and look at some of the top comments here in a minute. We'll go through just a few more quick. I'm getting Discord messages now. Let's see. Community. Can we get premium for rank 5 for Japan and UK, please? Gaijin, here another rank 4, no, 5 premium for the US. And an unusable rank 5 premium above 150 meters for the British. What they should have made the X1 or the XM1 a non-premium and gave Xbox a low-tier tank, because now there's going to be more tier 6 US, and again, MM or Matchmaker is going to be broken, and blah, blah, blah. I've seen some people, again, I would still have the same issue. They could give them a Battle Rating 1.0 exclusive tank. I would still have the same issue I'm having now. These are just people that don't like the idea that they're getting access to a top-ranked tank. And yes, I do agree to an extent with that. The PlayStation 4 players, excuse me, got access to the A26, okay? Which is rank 4, attacker. But it's an attacker. It's not some badass, you know, overpowered plane, fighter, or anything like that. And then they turn around and they make Xbox get this rank 5 tank exclusive. That's some ridiculous, in my opinion, personally. Only saving grace is that the GM version is exclusive to PC and PS4, so maybe it evens out. It does not even out. I simply don't like the thought of a premium Abrams period in the early game too soon, or this early in the game too soon. I mean, it gives people an extra incentive to play on Xbox over PS4, but it still screws over everybody in the current player base. I thought that Gaijin... Oh, no, that's for that thing. Why are they premium Gaijin? You want to rape wallets? They always want to rape wallets. I don't know if that's a bad thing. Gaijin probably signed an agreement to make Xbox-only tanks. It's probably in their contract. That would make sense. That's Centurion again. Your thought process at the start was very much what I went through. I thought very much what you said your V1 of this video were, or where the GM was premium and the C was tech tree. And then I read that the C was Xbox only and GM was premium, and it seems like I was and am very much in the same boat as you, with being very angry that America, which already has very much the top tier, is getting more top tier bullshit. Thank you for showing that it isn't just me that was rather pissed and or at America getting effectively three M1s, but two being tier 5, and one of them was PC and PS4 players will probably never get, or us PS4, yeah, whatever, fuck it. You get what he's trying to say. Also, the Xbox exclusive XM1C, it seems that Xbox will be coming with 1.79. Well, I would assume. Oh, wait, no, he means that maybe now Xbox is going to be released with 1.79. Well, yeah, that would make sense. Finally. They managed to go, but at this point, you know what, fuck the Xbox version, don't release it. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding, that was a joke. They managed to go the only route that guaranteed I wouldn't buy the again, I'm reading the wrong comments here. My account is linked to PS4 and PC, and I hope they're going to make it able to be linked to all three, because I will not grind another fucking account for this game. People that actually do, like, go to the PlayStation 4 from the PC and make a whole fucking new account and grind out the whole game again, holy shit, dude. I need all my shit in one place, right? I can't, like, go to the Xbox, grind out a tech tree, and then buy an exclusive there and say, oh, yeah, I've got it in my collection. Because it's not the same collection. It's separate. I like all the numbers and you know, statistics and vehicles to all be in one place. That's how I feel about Steam. That's why I use Steam over trying to, unless I have to use Uplay or Origin or something like that. I try to keep everything in the same place. I've got all my games there. That's where I do a lot of my communication. I've got all my statistics there and all this stuff. I like everything in one place. That's why I don't have separate YouTube channels. All Let's Plays, War Thunder videos, home videos, everything. All in one place. That's why I do it. To be honest, though, we get the better one. Suck at console peasants, so I ain't even mad. The exclusion of one tank from PS4 and PC and only on Xbox is complete garbage. This is a big mistake on Gaijin's part. With the exclusion, they lost a lot of paying people. It's a bad decision on their part. So much money could have been made from the two together, three together, and not making one specific to one system and one to another. See, again, I completely agree with this person. I don't understand why they think they can make more money. Or maybe Gaijin doesn't think that, but that's what some people are saying, which I don't know if they're looking into it as deeply as they should be. Give me money, how so fucked up, but it is business. Unfortunately, you'll see in 1 year it will be available somewhere for PC after their Microsoft Xbox contract is done. Remember that famous Doentine Mother cardboard bullshit gift? Similar to what you have now. Oh, I think they're talking about Mother Cardboard. Yeah, so what they're talking about is a long time ago, there was the D521, which is a collectible British-French fighter. There was this French motherboard that was being sold for a limited time, and when you bought it, you got a code or something like that for the D521 in War Thunder. But it was a French motherboard, specifically. Or it wasn't a French motherboard, but it was like only sold in France, or it was some bullshit like that. It had some really weird... I could be wrong on this, but it had some like really weird rule to it. So that you know, not many people owned it. And then they brought it back a year or two later, or maybe 3 years later. I don't remember exactly when, 2014, 15 maybe. Which, I mean, hey, if that happens with this, fine, okay? If maybe they only get it for a certain amount of time and then it's available for everyone, that's a different story. But they're not exactly leading on to it being that way. Well, I guess we'll have to see. But I would like to say that that's the case, but guess what? 826 C45DT, where's that at? Just bought the TU-114, stop milking my money. Money talks, babe. This is marketing. This is not marketing. Milk that shit. Milk it. Well, I mean, it's marketing for, if we're talking about the General Motors, yeah, it's marketing. You know, it's milking and money and stuff. But again, I'm referring to the Chrysler version. Might also help for you to know that Microsoft might be the one that made Gaijin do it. Yes, it's basically, they may be the one that's causing it to happen. They have to have an exclusive or something like that. It's really dumb. Stop being such a fucking crybaby. Absolutely disgusting behavior. You've lost me here, right here, mate. Or right there, mate. Here's this awesome tank that you can't get. You literally have the exact same tank for PC and PS4 anyway. Grow the fuck up and stop the crybaby shit. Again, another person who doesn't understand the point of collecting, and another dumb version, or another dumb comment including this, it's the same shit bullshit. I mean, if you want to call me a fucking crybaby because of the video, I can understand, because I went pretty fucking complainy in that video. You can disagree with me you know, and say that shit. But the moment you bring up this excuse that they're both the same vehicles, you've lost me there, mate. Now that's Centurion. Let's fuck the players that keep keeping this game alive just for memes. I don't know what's memey about it. So mad that you don't even look at the skull decal. I did look at the skull decal. You don't realize that this is an awesome decal to have either. I did look at it. I was in the video in the middle of my ranting, I was like, oh, okay, so here's what the pack gets. It gets a skull decal. Fucking sucks. I hate skulls. And then I moved on. That's exactly, it was only a few seconds. I did look at it. And because I was very angry in the video, I didn't care about it. But let me try and explain it again. Skull decal, I don't like it. It's badass, sure, to some. I hate skulls. I fucking hate skulls. I hate watching people, I hate going out to the store, right? And going to look for like a new sweatshirt or a new shirt or something, and all it is skulls, 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 skulls. I hate them. If it's an animal skull, fuck yeah. I'll wear a shirt about that, but not a fucking human skull. They're so overused and so absolutely annoying, in my opinion. I don't think it looks cool at all. That doesn't mean it's not cool, though. It is cool. I can appreciate that people would like this, but I don't personally like it. That's why I skipped over it in the video, but I did look at it for at least half a second. You have to give me some credit. Now, it's kind of funny that the fact that you get punched in the gut by not getting the G model. Okay, hold on a minute. Whoops, fuck. Okay, hold on. Alright, there's a shitload of comments here. There's tons of people on here. There's a very small percentage of the people that commented. I mean, if we look at the video, if we pause this here. I mean, look at the like to dislike ratio here. 23, well, if I take my like away. 23 dislikes, 197 likes, okay? For a rant video of mine where I really get angry, that is extremely appreciated, because normally when I get very angry in my videos and make, you know, some rant video like this, it's usually 197 dislikes and 23 likes, you know, something along those lines. With 3,600 views right now, and without a doubt in the next couple days, it's probably going to reach 5,000 views, and there's going to be more comments and more like to dislike ratios coming in. By the way, Battlefield 5 tomorrow, so we'll have to be looking into that. Anyways, let's see what some of the top comments here are. That's not the top comment, that's what I wrote. Okay, that's not the top. The top comment is actually, what a joke. 59 upvotes. This person here says, my feelings are so incredibly mixed. The Abrams is my absolute favorite series of tanks of all time. I'm even in the process of writing a novel which heavily features it. I'm super hyped to finally have an opportunity to drive a number of the series without sacrificing endless days and nights to grind through boring World War II stuff. Boring World War II stuff. Excuse me? And painful US Tier 5 stuff. At the same time, as a massive fan of the Abrams series, it's super disappointing that I can't have the Chrysler prototype in my collection, especially with it being the one that ultimately became the M1. I understand. It's fucking shit. I know how it feels. Even though I don't look at the M1 the same way as you, I can actually very well imagine that this person's a little bit more distressed than me, because they actually really care about the vehicle's history itself. When myself finds the M1 Abrams just to be cool, but I never really looked into its history all that much. It's got four things here. Sadly, as a console pleb, I was never able to play the Arma series. I've played a little bit of it. That's a story for another day. Take another drink here. What a joke. One of them should be in the tech tree. I feel like Germany is going to get trash. 1.7 is going from best to pretty bad. I'm assuming they're talking about 1.79. They just missed their 9 in there. These tanks shouldn't be premium, but normal tech tree tanks like 2K was normal tech tree for Germans, but oh well, Gaijin and Sense doesn't go well together. I agree. Still gonna buy it, but it hurts. I thought the X1MC was tech tree tank. So did I. I can understand them. They want to lure Xbox players, but a tech tree version would have been better. Yeah, okay, so you get the idea. Comment section on the website and in my comment section, very much a majority of the players are completely against Gaijin's decision on this. So here are some things that I think would have been able, that you could do to make it far better, where people aren't so fucking angry. The first thing is, don't make it exclusive. The first thing is that you could make it available for all three platforms. Make it available for all three. Normally, you know, have if you have to have two premium XM1s, General Motors and a Chrysler version, okay? Or have one on the tech tree and one premium for all platforms. But obviously, they've already made their mind up that both of them will be premium, so that's not going to happen. Another thing you could do is if you want to make it exclusive to Xbox, you could do it one of two different ways. The same way that the one of the comment person that we read through said, you could make it where they will release it at a later date after the contract ends or whatever. Then everybody gets access to it. It's just like Xbox players get it early access while everybody else has to wait. It's annoying, but at least that way it's fair to everyone. Everyone gets access to the tank. And if you do that, you have to let the General Motors version be purchased on the Xbox version as well. Otherwise, you can do the opposite way and do it this way. If you want to make the Chrysler version exclusive to the Xbox player base and General Motors, maybe here's what you can do. You can release the pack. You can release the Chrysler pack for a limited time on the website, on the store, or in-game or wherever, for everybody to purchase for a limited time, maybe like 1 month or 2 weeks or something. Like, here, the Chrysler XM1 will be available for 2 weeks, and you can be able to purchase it. After those 2 weeks is up, it will be removed from the store and only available on the Xbox Live Store, whatever it's called, Xbox One Live Store, whatever. I don't know what it's called. You know, that is the other way you could do it, to allow everybody a chance to get the Chrysler for buying it, and then they get to add it to their collection, then the Xbox players just get it normally, or something like that, right? And then maybe bring it back in the future, or something like that. You know, I think that's probably one way that that would be such a cash grab, guys, and you'd make so much fucking money if you did it that way, if you made the Chrysler available for a limited time. You know, that's how you should do it. If you have to do an exclusive, you should do it that way, not a different way. What you should do is one on standard, one on premium. That's what I think is the best way to do it. Even though I'm not fully happy that they're getting another tier 5 premium. In fact, it'd be best if both are on the tech tree, like, you know, having both of them. But then again, you have to, I mean, I know that it's not a comparison that I should make because it's a tier 5 premium, but you also have to think about, like, it's a similar story with the Tiger Henschel and the Porsche Tiger. The Tiger P is a premium, Tiger Henschel is not. So it kind of makes sense here if you had, like, the Chrysler on the standard tech tree, because it was the winning version of the prototype, or what would become the M1 Abrams, and then you had the General Motors version as a premium. It's very exact like the Tiger H and the Tiger P. You got the winning design on the standard tech tree and the prototype, but you've got the non-winning design as a premium. I think that's awesome. I think that works out very, very, very well. But that's not how they're doing it. So, fuck. You know? I'm getting lots of Discord messages. Anyways, I think that's probably about to bring this video to an end. All you have to do is fucking just make it exclusive, or make, you know, let us buy it. Do this thing where, right now, where you bring up the Chrysler pack, PC players and PS4 players have a limited time to buy it, you know, just for a limited time, right before the update comes out, for maybe a week or 2 weeks or something like that, maybe even a few days. People can buy it, they can add it to their collection, then it's removed from the store, the update is released, and then Xbox players have a limited time to buy the General Motors version, while they also still get automatic access to the Chrysler, while we have automatic access to the General Motors. That way, everybody somewhat wins in that case, because everybody can gain access to it right away, and then in the future, re-release the packs through, like, a special event like Victory Day or something like that. Although that wouldn't make much sense, because they're not Victory Day vehicles, but you get what I'm saying. You know, through some celebration, maybe the M1 Abrams, you know, anniversary or something like that. You could do something, just release one of the packs. Something like that. This is a very easy way to do it. Or maybe do that for the Chrysler. Just wait and release it for everybody during some anniversary. You know, there's so many better ways that you can do this. Anyways, I think that's going to bring this one to an end. We're up to 1 hour and 19 minutes. This is a very long video, but I felt like it needed to be made, and I actually feel very good about it. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next War Thunder update.